today on Florida Sport Fishing.
Look at that rig.
I like it. I like
Hold
it.
On. Hold on to him.
Woo! Fatty.
He's going to be on the surface.
Hold on. We'll take that size all day.
Ho ho, what on?
CB Boats presents Florida Sport Fishing, television for the avid angler. Powered by Mercury Marine.
Oh, got one on. There's a sailfish, already got a bite.
Ridiculous.
Another one on.
That's what it's all about right there. Yeah. Oh, look at that.
Florida Sport Fishing TV utilizes and proudly endorses Ghost, the global leader in boat security, monitoring, tracking, and surveillance. Motor Guide, the most dependable trolling motors on the water. VMC, tired of missed strikes? Fish the hooks the pros fish. Fish VMC. Rugged Shark, technical footwear designed for angling and boating enthusiasts. Ocean LED, for quality, high-performance underwater lighting, turn to Ocean LED.
Hey guys, welcome to Florida Sport Fishing TV. We've got a really, really cool episode in store. I'm Captain Mike. We've got Captain Carlos up on the bow, Chris O'Neill up on the bow with Carlos, and we are dropping down for Goliath grouper over here inside Boca Grande. Just really, really awesome fishery. There's a lot of exciting fisheries in Charlotte Harbor and this whole region, redfish, snook, trout, tarpon are everywhere. But there's something really special about this Goliath fishing. These fish will range from 40 to 400 pounds. Can you imagine a 400 pound grouper in 25 feet of water? But I'll tell you what, they live right here on these old phosphate docks. And they just cruise around this old weathered dock system that was built way back in the 1800s. Ships used to come in here, load up with phosphate, and then they used to transport it from here. You drop a bait to the bottom, 600 pound test, locked up, and just hold on for dear life.
Let it down there. Let him eat it. Don't raise the rod tip.
Oh, I did. I did it.
Just leave it there.
I think the bait's gone.
Okay,
now.
You got swipe.
Yeah.
All right, let's do a bait tip.
Get clean?
Yeah, it feels like it came right off. I think we need a bigger hook. You think we need a bigger hook?
20 out. Now, you always hook them the same way, Chris, right under that lip right there?
Yeah, we were tail hooking them before.
And when do you, you know, well,
when
you
they get aggressive,
that?
I like to do it like this.
Okay.
Simply because.
Does current matter at all? Like,
it does. Yeah. It absolutely does matter. Yeah. The direction the fish are going to be facing. They're right. Always facing the current. So.
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to get you right back up in the honey hole again. Drop that mullet right to the bottom and feed it to one of them.
Didn't take long.
Now we're fishing, as you can see, really, really heavy tackle. I mean, excessively heavy tackle. 600 pound test, leader materials all the way up to 1,000 pound test, 20-0 hooks. But there's a reason for that. These fish are fully protected. You don't want to exhaust them. You know, you want to just get in there, guerrilla battle them, fight it out real quick, tug of war, get them to the top and release them as quickly as possible. And you need this heavy gear. Now you can see what's happening here is Carlos has his bait right on the bottom. Chris is right next to him, just getting ready to give him the assist. Because again, you hook one of these super slobs and it's more than a one-man job.
Back up. Full reverse. There we go. Keep your rod tip down, point toward the fish.
Hold on, baby, nice, hold on.
Holy.
Take your time.
You're in open water, baby! Big fish! Oh, yeah!
This is what it's all about. Carlos, drop down that mullet.
You got that better fish.
Ooh, that's a nice one.
He's over a buck.
Oh, yeah. And this is really just another juvenile, isn't it, Chris? I mean,
yeah, 100 pounder. Just
right. 80, 100 pounds.
100 pounder. Just throw it around. 100
just
pounds.
A little baby. You can see why we're fishing those circle hooks. I mean, no harm done to that fish. It's right there in the corner of the lip right there. Another really cool thing about these Goliath grouper, and of course all of the divers, snorkelers, scuba divers will tell you this, that have stumbled upon these fish down, you know, on reefs and wrecks. They've got this ability to make this loud grunting noise, almost like a rumble, like a Goliath rumble. And they use their air bladder to do that. And you know, they're very territorial, so a lot of guys believe they make that big grunting noise, that almost like a roar to kind of scare off, you know, other intruders, other Goliaths that are trying to, you know, step on their property. And also that noise transmits through the water for a great distance. It's also believed that they communicate with that grunting noise as well. So just another awesome characteristic of this incredible fish that we're really fortunate to have down here in South Florida.
Mercury engine test.
Smooth, quiet power you can rely on. It's good to have Mercury behind you.
It's your turn to score big. Book a long-range adventure aboard the legendary Yankee Captains. Fish virgin waters more than 100 miles offshore for exotic queen snapper, trophy tilefish, monster grouper, and more. With a lifetime of experience, let Captain Greg Mercurio and his dedicated crew put you on a hot bite. Fish around the clock or just relax. With full galley and huge fish boxes, all you'll need to bring is your appetite for action. Now sailing from Key West year-round.
Fortress, the world's best anchors. Stronger, faster, lighter. High-tech aluminum alloy makes Fortress anchors the easiest to handle. Precision machining and sharpening results in the fastest setting anchor. Fortress buries deep for the strongest holding power. With 8 models from 4 to 69 pounds, there's a Fortress anchor for you. Fortress, stronger, faster, lighter.
Mercury engine test.
Easy to maintain performance you can rely on. It's good to have Mercury behind you.
What's your seasons here? I mean, obviously, catching redfish year-round. Throughout all of Charlotte Harbor, or what's peak season?
Redfish is the best redfish season where you can target them is latter part of August, September, and into October. October is my favorite month of fish.
Okay.
I call it Fishtoberfest because not a lot of people take advantage of it, but there's multiple species, nearshore migration, everything's going south. There's so many things to do around here in October and September.
October.
Oh, it's amazing. Fall. It's so good.
And the Goliaths, you can catch them year round?
Minus the real cold months of December, January. I don't target them. Just I could go catch them, but I like to leave them alone. You know, just as a, you know, I think they're a little more vulnerable during that time, like any other species. So we kind of tune it down to trout and, you know, redfish. All right, we're in the meat. He's on there.
I got it.
Oh, you bro.
Back up.
Go. Carlos. Nice and easy. Straight back. Fish on.
Where are you?
Fish on, baby.
Almighty.
You got a hookup, baby. You got a hookup. I like it.
Real. Oh, yeah, okay, pal.
Real. There he is.
Oh, yeah, that's a little puppy.
Oh, he's
and
so
he
cute.
And he ate that whole mullet.
That's
Look
a newborn.
Look at that thing.
Yeah.
Dude. That thing's got to be, what, 20 pounds? And
ate
like a 5-pound
mullet. Yeah. He's at least
that's
40.
Insane.
Dude, how old do you think that fish is? Maybe 3 years old?
A couple of 3 years old.
Two,
yeah,
3 years old.
It's a newborn fish.
Yep.
Insane.
Now, of course, with Goliath grouper, these fish have been fully protected all over the United States here since 1990. So you certainly can't harvest these fish, and you really don't even want to take them out of the water at all. That's actually considered harvesting the fish, even taking it out of the water. A lot of guys, you know, Chris, believe that the population of Goliath grouper has really rebounded so strongly that there should be a limited harvest. What do you think?
We just concluded a 3-year study which is going to capture that data, the actual numbers, not the rumor numbers,
right,
or the species counts, what they're actually feeding
an
on.
An actual stock assessment.
Yep. Mm-hmm. And then determine, based on scientific facts, not somebody's opinion,
right,
on what to do, which is a neat thing if you think about it.
Oh, 100%. I mean, you know, so many anglers, you know, they moan and groan because they feel that there's so many Goliaths that they're eating all of the jacks, all of the forage species, the lobsters. permit on the wrecks, juvenile cobia, that they pretty much eat everything, and that these are the only real apex predators that are down there. But like you said, with that stock assessment and that real study, we'll be able to know exactly how many are out there. Look at that mouth.
Ate a 5-pound mullet, dude.
That thing just swallowed a 5-pound mullet.
Yeah, like nothing.
Oh, people don't realize the teeth on there. I mean, the
teeth and structure.
You got ribbed teeth. Serious teeth. They've got all kinds of
chompers down there. Another thing to remember, these goliath are really, really slow growing fish. They're believed to live to 40, even 50 years old. But I'll tell you, I've learned, Chris, and maybe you can confirm, once they're around 20, 25, they only grow about a quarter of an inch a year.
That's absolutely correct.
Super, super slow. So it's so important that these fish are protected, the largest of all Atlantic grouper species. And we'll see you later, baby. You go back to mama. Go back to mama. Go ahead. There you go.
Sweet.
Rigging Station, presented by Diamond Fishing Products, makers of the finest monofilament and braided fishing line in the world.
Hi, and welcome to this episode's Rigging Station. If you're just catching up, we're over here in Charlotte Harbor fishing Boca Grande for goliath grouper, having an absolute ball. These things are insane. It's just a crazy fishery. But I wanted to talk to you a little bit more about our tackle and make sure that if you want to come out here and try this, that you're rigged right, or else you're going to be wasting your time. We started off with an Alutechnos 50 wide loaded with 600 pound test monofilament sock down drag, as tight as you can get that drag. Absolutely no leeway at all, just sock down. Reels matched to a Chaos Rodzilla rod, roller guides rated for 80 to 130 pound line. This is just about the heaviest rod that Chaos will build. Again, you really need some beefy, beefy equipment, not only because you have an opportunity of hooking fish that might be 400 or 500 pounds, but also because it's really just down and dirty fish, and you're pulling these fish out of really just intense rubble and intense debris up along those pilings, and you need something that can withstand that. Our rig itself, we've got our 600 pound running line crimped to a really heavy duty ball bearing swivel. From there, we've got a 1,000 pound leader, about 4 or 5 feet, 1,000 pound. Again, this is rubbing up on those pilings, and you can see from all of the fish that we've caught here today, the leader's just all chafed up already, but still works, that's for sure. Make sure that your connections are crimped. I mean, you've got to have solid connections. Again, there's absolutely no leeway here. From there, the working end of the rig, we've got a 16 ounce egg sinker. That's what's going to take your bait right to the bottom. That's crimped in place to a 20-0 circle hook. Sounds like a super big hook. It is a super big hook. But again, these fish are huge, and you need a large hook that'll hook that fish right in the corner of the mouth so you can also release them as quickly as possible. And that's another benefit to this tackle. These fish are protected, and a lot of them are spawning. You don't want to exhaust these big goliaths. You want to hook them, you want to battle them, get them to the surface as quickly as possible, take a couple pictures while that fish is in the water, and get him back on his way as quickly as possible.
The award-winning Z Performance line from CV raises the bar. It's not just fast. It's not just fuel efficient. The CVZ is the entire package. It offers the perfect balance, safe, predictable handling during hard turns and at high speed. And most importantly, the Z stays on plane at lower speed, so it can comfortably handle anything Mother Nature can dish out. Experience the exhilarating ride of the CVZ. Schedule a sea trial today.
Want more power and increased towing capacity? California Customs goes beyond the hitch. Let us transform your truck into the ultimate tow vehicle. Two and four-wheel drive, California Customs does it all. Towing accessories and load control systems, lift and leveling kits, custom wheels and tires, performance upgrades, toolboxes, and bed covers, plus all of your audio, lighting, and security needs. California Customs, let us make your vehicle what you really wanted all along.
Chaos is tragic. Chaos can be awesome.
Yo, another one on! Another one on! Three on, baby!
With Chaos Fishing, it's your rod your way. Quality components and personalized service from a legendary builder equal the right rod at the right price every time. Shop online for a complete selection of serious fishing equipment. Or visit Chaos's new superstore and receive a free t-shirt with every rod purchase. Chaos Fishing, gear matters.
What if navigating was as simple as touch and go? It is that simple. The world's first multi-touch MFT chart plotter, Navnet TZ Touch.
I just did the Goliath grouper dance.
Uh-oh.
There he is, leap it down.
Back up.
Put it reverse, just go straight back. You got him. Let him eat it.
He ate it, dude.
I know.
Yeah,
we got it.
Let him. Me?
He's on there. Just go straight back. Don't do anything. Don't start reeling.
Okay.
Let the boat reel.
Okay.
He's on there.
Hold on, Carlos, hold on.
Where are you going? Come on up here, baby.
Dude, I'm.
You got him. Come on. Don't let him go in the junk. I like it. Reel. Up. Go, baby. You got him. Guys to the sky, baby. I like it. There we go. That's what I'm talking about.
You got him.
That's gorilla fishing, baby.
That's it.
Woo.
Nice.
What do you guys exactly do to really evaluate what the population of these fish is all about?
You know, Mike, it's been a great study. The University of Florida, Florida State, and Florida Southern got together with the Florida Wildlife Commission and the NOAA and the Florida Fisheries. And what they did was they came up with a system where they authorized about 50 guides in the state to have a permit to actually possess the fish. We all had to go through training.
You can't harvest them, but you can possess them.
Right.
They
taught us how to bring them on the boat, okay. Keep them resuscitated, and do whatever studies we need to do. We did an age sample. We did stomach samples. What we determined is these fish eat slow-moving fish, stingrays, a lot of crab. Most 90% of the time, it's a big crab, a blue crab.
That's their primary diet.
Absolutely.
Slow-moving crustaceans.
Yeah, some mullet, but never. Are they going to free swim and catch a red snap or anything? Those are always the ones that are chased down once they're hooked on a reef. So that's the big misconception there, Mike. Mm-hmm. It's a beautiful fish.
It really is.
That fish is probably around 10 years old, maybe 5 to 10 years old.
Gorgeous. Surprising for a fish that has a big gullet like that, how that thing will primarily pick off crabs.
Certainly, like you said.
I mean, and you can see he's got all those crunchers, all those teeth up at the top of his mouth there. He's got teeth on the bottom of his lip there, on the bottom of his mouth. And if you look down his throat, it looks like he's got some crunchers down there as well, I guess, to crush those lobsters and crabs.
You see that sediment, like all in his mouth too? Is that from maybe picking up the sand, eating the crabs and stuff too?
It could be. Yeah. He could be regurgitating whatever he was eating this morning.
Wow, but I mean, look at that.
You can put a basketball in his mouth.
Oh, easy. Stick your head in there, dude.
Watermelon.
Boom.
Awesome.
Right out.
Great release.
Nice and healthy. Look at that. There you go, pal. We'll see you later.
There we go. Go get him. He's wrapped.
Oh.
You're right. There, he's out. Go. Get him. Up.
Oh,
he's gonna be on the surface. He's gonna be on the surface. There he is. Yeah, see him. He's up top.
Nice.
There he is. Better fish.
There you go. Oh, yeah.
Oh, baby.
Hey, we'll take that. We'll take that size all day.
What do you think about the power of that thing with that kind of line?
Oh. Just brute, man.
Just complete drag lockdown.
Yeah.
It's you and the fish.
This is it.
That is what's nice about it.
Yeah.
You're right.
It's you,
just
and, the
you
fish.
And the fish, man.
Yeah. Who's going to win the tug of war?
Yep. The one thing, these things have been fully protected since 1990. You can't harvest them. You can't take them out of the water. But prior to that, in the 70s and 80s, spear fishermen used to go out and just absolutely annihilate these things. You know, there have been photos and documentation of 3 or 4 spear fishermen going out and spearing 5,000 pounds of Goliath grouper. You know, it just seems like such a waste. I can't believe that.
That
was crazy. Some of the historic photos that we've seen, there was just absolutely no respect for these fish. And, you know, they certainly deserve a tremendous amount of respect.
I'll tell you what, you battle one like that, you'll gain all the respect you need.
You're 100% right, dude. One-on-one just like that, that's the way to do it.
Gear Guide, presented by Pelagic High Performance Offshore Gear, official apparel of Florida Sport Fishing TV.
Hi, I'm Captain Mike, and I hope you're enjoying watching this episode as much as I enjoyed filming it. You guys know I'm a huge fan of CV boats. Our 370Z is the ultimate offshore platform. It's just a perfect combination of fit and finish and efficiency and performance. And I'll tell you what, while this boat is super comfortable in nearly any sea conditions, at the end of the day, it's really all about putting more fish in the boat. Recently, while filming a couple of inshore episodes, I've had an opportunity to experience CV's new mercury-powered 270Z bay boat. And let me tell you, this thing is an absolute dream machine, inshore and off, with CV characteristics through and through. With CV's introduction into the bay boat market with the 270Z, they've really broken all of the barriers for Gulf Coast anglers by designing the perfect platform for inshore and nearshore fishermen who also want the ability to fish distant wrecks and reefs when conditions permit. While CV sells and builds all of their boats down in Miami, Florida, they've recently opened up a new sales office on the outskirts of Tampa where Gulf Coast fishermen can pop in at any time to learn more about these incredible fishing machines. The modern, comfortable facility is always open to the public with no pressure whatsoever and always has a number of different models on hand for demos. Call CV's new Tampa office today and schedule a sea trial and experience for yourself how CV boats are built better, how they perform better, and how they fish better. Let's keep backing up, Carlos.
I got it, dude. I'm good. Just hold on. Hold on to him. Hold on to him.
Oh, Nelly.
Pretty good fish.
Yeah.
Woo. Better fish. We're getting up there.
Fatty. If you've never done this before, you've got to come out here to Charlotte Harbor, Boca Grande. Check out Captain Chris O'Neill. Chris, your website?
Tailchasercharters.com.
Tailchasercharters.com. This guy's landed 500 of these things in the last 3 years. So if I was going to fish with anybody out here, this is the ticket right here, Captain Chris O'Neill. And I'll tell you, when you come out to the West Coast here, we're staying at the Wannabe Inn, just up in Englewood up the road. Perfect place, man. You can launch your boat right there. Safe parking for your trailer. Full accommodations in the rooms, right on the beach. Convenient to a wide array of different fisheries. I can't say enough about it, and affordable. Really affordable, great place for families. Couple of swimming pools there. The Wannabe Inn in Englewood. Check it out.
Are you ready to get hooked up? Florida Sport Fishing is the number one resource for the latest tips, tricks, tactics, and techniques for inshore and offshore. Each issue is jam-packed with useful articles, easy-to-follow illustrations, and award-winning photography. Only $30 for 2 years. For immediate home delivery, visit floridasportfishing.com/TV. Subscribe today and receive a free shirt and Florida Sport Fishing Hoorag.
Hi, I'm Captain Horace on the Desert Escape. We just got back in from fishing today. Got us a nice little wahoo. Looks like it'll probably go about 30 pounds. Let me give the new bubble blade a try here. Man, that is like butter. Still got a good grip. It doesn't seem to be sliding out of my hand. How nice is that? Unbelievable. That right there is what makes a bigger knife so nice.
When you want to get away from it all, to a place where you can do everything or nothing at all, surrounded by natural beauty and all the modern amenities you might desire, then you'll want to be here at the Wannabe Inn on the beautiful shores of Manasota Key, Florida. To plan your escape, log on to wannabein.com.
Florida Sport Fishing TV utilizes and proudly endorses Salt Life Sport Optics. Ask for them by name and see what you've been missing. Tropic Trailer, Florida's largest dealer, has the right trailer at the right price. BoatOutfitters.com, a huge selection of tackle storage units to keep your gear organized and your lines tight. Dr. Dan's, from lip balm to sunblock, a complete skincare line designed for anglers and boaters. Frigid Rigid, from 35 to 300 quarts, the finest coolers and freezers on the water.
Oh, wait, I'm in the junk. No, I'm clear.
Just walk him right out. Nice and easy. Bumping in and out. Go right, and then we'll hit back. All right. Now hit hard back reverse. Go, 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 go. Now shorten up that line. Here we go, here we go. Nice and easy, nice and easy. Nice and easy, he's in clean water. Keep going back, bro. What do you think about that chaos rod?
That's the way to catch him right there, baby. That's the way to catch him.
Yeah, Goliath have a lot more torque and a lot more power than, say, a gag, just because of the way they're designed. I mean, that thing, and you pulled them out of some serious structure there.
Goliath on the spinner.
Hold on, hold on, hold on, baby, hold on.
Face the fish. There you go, brother.
There you go.
Easy, easy, easy.
Get him, Carlos, get him.
That's a good one, dude. That's a good one. That's a good one.
What are you doing? Who's driving the boat?
Nobody.
We're watching you. We're hanging out. We're having a good time.
Boca Grande, I can't say it enough, man. We love all kinds of fishing, but this is really, really exciting. If you've never done this, you need to get over here and enjoy this Goliath fishing. Yeah, nice one.
That's a big one. That's a big one.
Nice. All right.
On spinning gear.
We had an absolutely awesome trip out here to the West Coast. You know, guys come out here to fish for tarpon, redfish, snook, trout. There's just a world of different fisheries available out here. We came out here for one purpose, Goliath grouper fishing. Captain Chris O'Neill, right here. Chris, one more time, your website.
BocaGrandTarpon.com. Check us out and we'll take you fishing.
We'll put you on the meat, baby, that's for sure. We'll put you on the meat and on the money.
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, look at that. Yeah, that's a good one.
To learn more about the tactics and techniques seen on today's show, and to subscribe to Florida Sport Fishing Magazine, visit FloridaSportFishing.com and get hooked up.